हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 125। जियो यूजर्स कैन नाउ अवेल ऑफ अप टू 5 इमरजेंसी डेटा लोन्स ऑफ 1 GB ईच वैल्यूड एट 11 rupees पर पैक। जियो यूजर्स नीड टू हैव एन एक्टिव प्लान टू ऑप्ट फॉर द डेटा लोन पैक। द इमरजेंसी डेटा लोन पैक विल बी एक्टिव अंटिल द बेस प्लान वैलिडिटी। The Department of Telecommunication may likely ask Tribe views on tariffs of prepaid plans. This development comes soon after Vodafone Idea claims that tariffs are below cost and needs to be examined. Besides, the telecom operator wants DOT to increase the time period of payment of spectrum dues. Since the last couple of months, there have been reports about upcoming WhatsApp feature that will solve the problem that everyone faces when they switch from an Android phone to iPhone or vice versa. Now, WhatsApp Beta Information, the online platform that tracks the changes and upcoming features of WhatsApp, has posted a small clip showing how exactly this transfer of WhatsApp chats could look like when a user is switching from iPhone to an Android phone. Samsung is gearing up for its mega launch event later this year. The South Korean tech giant will host its Galaxy Unpacked 2021 event to launch flagship products. Samsung is yet to announce the official launch date of its event. The company is likely to unveil the Galaxy Z Fold 3 and Flip 3, the Galaxy Watch 4 series and the new Galaxy earbuds. TikTok is currently the major social media platform for sharing short 60-second videos, but from the start of quarter 2 2021, creators will have even more time for their videos. In an official message, the product manager of TikTok has revealed the service will be rolling out an option to create longer videos of up to 3 minutes. Xiaomi Mi 11 Ultra was launched back in April, bearing a price tag of ₹70,000. The device has not gone on sale yet, but that will soon change it. The company has now commenced registration for the Mi 11 Ultra as it prepares to sell the phone in India for the first time. The registration process involved buying the Ultra gift card at ₹2,000, that is $27, with the accompanying F code that qualifies you to purchase the Mi 11 Ultra during yet to be announced date of limited sale, with additional free gifts also on offer. On the day of the sale of Mi 11 Ultra, any users who completes the purchase using the Ultra gift card will get 2 free screen replacements, Ultra branded merchandise, Time Prime annual membership, a super fan box and an additional Ultra F code. The Redmi Note 9 Pro Max launched in early 2020 as the first ever Redmi Note 10 Pro Max model. The handset dubbed with MIUI 11 based Android 10, the device was updated to the MIUI 12 last year. Now it has been finally updated that it is receiving the Android 11 update for a year after. Vivo Y72 5G will launch in India on July 15. A leaked official poster image reveals the Vivo Y72 5G Indian variant along with the bank offers and key specifications. Vivo Y72 5G price in India is expected to be under ₹20,000. This phone highlights the features like MediaTek Dimensity 700 chipset, 64-megapixel triple camera and a 5000mAh battery. If we see the mentioned leaked image, the Vivo Y72 5G will come with a flat ₹1,500 cashback through HDFC Bank, ICICI Banks and Kodak. You will get a one-time screen replacement and Jio benefits worth ₹10,000 on purchasing this phone. And we can expect to learn the official price on July 15th. ZTE may have plans to come with a 20 GB of RAM phone in the future. While the Chinese company has not yet provided any concrete details, one of the executives teased the development online. Companies including Asus and Lenovo have brought phones with 18 GB of RAM in the recent past. However, by bringing a 20 GB of RAM phone, ZTE could make the competition tougher for its rival South Asian smartphone vendors. The company is also amongst the key players working on bringing the under-display selfie camera phone last year. The world has changed a lot and thus the pollution level. TCL, which is known for making televisions worldwide, have recently launched an air purifier Breva A1, promising what one would expect an air purifier to do. Indeed, the HEPA H13 filter is designed to filter out 99.9% of the particles in the air. This should help against cigarette smoke among other things, but also against exhaust fumes, dust, pet fur, pollen, allergens and even odors. The Breva A1 from TCL is currently being sold on Amazon for the effective price of $49.99. DJI is the world's largest drone maker and has a wide array of drones for different segments of its growing global clientele. The last month, Walmart leaked the DJI Mini Software Edition drone to the US market, indicating the impending release in the US. However, the DJI has now unveiled the DJI Mini Software Edition and it will be available in the selected markets outside the US and Europe. The mini drone has already appeared on some DJI websites like DJI Brazil, which sales have begun in Malaysia. Garena Free Fire cross event with Street Fighter V is now live called as Free Fighter. The event brings elements of the popular fighting game to the battlegrounds of Free Fire. This includes outfit, emotes, skin and many more. The interface will also see an overhaul to better represent the crossover event. A high-end Tesla Model S plate caught fire Thursday night in Haverford, Pennsylvania, briefly trapping the driver inside. According to the local fire department, lawyer for the coroner said that vehicle spontaneously combusted. The firefighters, who had been trained on how to respond to battery fires involving Tesla vehicles, laid a 5-inch supply line into the scene so that we could keep a continuum water stream on the fire to distinguish the fire and the cool. The driver managed to escape and there were no injuries. Battlegrounds Mobile India was released officially in the country on July 2nd. The PUBG Mobile alternative was available for early access download on June 18th. Krafton has made the game available for everyone on Android. Eligible devices can download the Battle Royale from the Google Play Store within a hour of its official release. The Battlegrounds Mobile India has crossed over 10 million downloads. The company also rewarded players for helping achieving the milestone. Meanwhile, the BGMI is currently topping the charts on the Google Play Store. The game is currently at the top spot of the top free application section of the Google Play Store. OnePlus has announced that it is merging its Oxygen OS with Oppo's Color OS to improve the efficiency and standardize the software experience across devices. The new move by the Chinese company comes just a couple of weeks after it announced its formal merger with OPPO on the BKK Electronics. However, the companies decided to make their collaboration public and they integrated their research and development resources. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.